Do you want to check if your WordPress posts are ranking for the right keywords? Well, keep watching. In this video, I'll show you three methods you can use to check your keyword rankings for WordPress. A lot of beginners tend to go to Google and simply type in the keywords for their website to see where they're ranking. But this isn't really accurate. See, Google uses a personalized setting, and they already know the sites that you've already gone to and the things that you already look for. So checking the rankings like this might give you skewed results, but that's okay. There's certain ways that you can look at your rankings and see how you're doing for your keywords on your site. And we'll cover those next. The first one we'll look at is called SEMRush or SEMrush, depending on how you want to say it. And this is a great way to enter either a domain or a keyword or a specific URL to see what that site is ranking for. So you can enter the URL there, and by default, SEMrush will allow you to do some basic results without paying. So you get a good feel for the tool and if you want to move forward with purchasing it. So right out of the gate, you can see that there are some rankings on this. To do the test version, they may ask you to create a user account, and you usually get 10 free searches a day. So once you see everything initially, you can check out the historical traffic over the years, and this is great for all time, or you can dig in, drill down a little bit. You can also scroll all the way down and you see the top keywords that the site that you're looking at is ranking for. You'll also see the main competitors in the list, and from here you can click on full report and it'll give you a few more as the free trial. What you want to do for your site is put in your site or put in the keyword that you're trying to rank for and see the results here. The best way to use this to your advantage is to find the keywords that you're ranking, say, on the top page of Google, but maybe not in the top three results. So your main area that you want to work on to improve those pages is maybe at position 4 through 10. And that's because the top three results in Google get the bulk of the clicks when somebody is searching in Google. And you see there are lots of information that you can look at and drill down to get more information about these keywords. So if this were our site, we would want to pick some of these that are also pertinent to our site, which means they're relevant to the pages on our site. So if we want to increase the potential of going higher in the search results, then there's some things that we can do to make that better. You can also export this to see the details of the keywords better and filter and sort a little bit easier in a CSV file so that you can work on that there. So that's method one for finding keywords for your site. The next method you want to do is make sure that you have Search Console set up. That's Google's Search Console set up for your website. And when you do that, you can start tracking your performance on your site. You can click on performance here, or you can click on performance here to dig down a little bit deeper. So once I click on the performance, you can see some graph and information on your site. These two are already highlighted. I'm gonna go ahead and click on this one to bring them up on the graph as well. And what this is doing is it's telling you how many times your website or pages on your website have shown up in Google results. Even if no one clicked on it, they've at least shown up. Your site has at least shown up. The clicks are when someone actually does click on your site once they've shown up in the search results. This is the average click-through rate of all of your keywords and all of your web pages on your site for the last 3 months. And then this is the average position for all of your keywords and all of your pages for the last 3 months as well. So that's a good overview. What I think is better is when you can go and drill down deeper into each of your pages. So to show you what I mean, I'm going to click on pages and I want to work on this top page here. So I want to see how I can make this top page better by improving different keywords here. So I'm going to click on that. So now this page is up here in my filter section for the last 3 months. And then I can scroll down. And now that I have this as a filter, I can click back on queries. And this will be all of the keywords that this page particularly is getting when somebody searches in Google. So this is a very powerful way to go through all of the keywords that are showing up in search results when someone types in these search keywords and how your pages are performing. What you can do here is you can also export all of the data here and then go through and, like with SEMrush, go through and focus on the keywords that are maybe at position 4 and higher to come up with a plan of action on how to improve that. So Search Console is very powerful. Now, a caveat with all of these tools, especially Search Console, is it is usually, it's supposed to be 2 days lag time. Right now, it's more like a 3.5 day lag time. So all of these positions and all of this ranking is as of 3.5 days ago. So it's a little difficult to see real-time rankings for that. You can see more real-time rankings if you have a paid tier for SEMrush and Ahrefs, which is the next tool that we'll talk about. So Ahrefs, or Ahrefs, however you want to say it, this is also a great tool. And what's great is you have a 7-day free trial for $7, but it gives you a lot of information. Very similar to SEMrush, it gives you a total amount of information that you can see how your site is doing, as well as keywords that you might want to see if they're worth ranking for your site, and then also for competitor research. These are great tools for that. So just like with SEMrush, you can put either your site in here at the top for Explorer, or you can put a competitor site in here and you'll get some information back. The biggest area that you would want to look for is the organic search here to see how your site is ranking for different keywords. Or you can also come over here. Two very powerful links are the top pages. So the top pages of your site that are ranking for the most keywords, and also the organic keywords of what your site's ranking for. So the top pages shows that for this particular website, there's like 132 keywords that this page ranks for, as well as the position of the top keyword. You can also go to organic keywords, and that's very similar to Search Console, Google Search Console, where you can see all of the rankings. Same thing with SEMrush and Search Console. You can export this data out so that then you can work on these keywords to improve the rankings on your site. And those are three great methods to see how your site is ranking for particular keywords. Did you learn something from today's video? If so, subscribe to our YouTube channel and we'll send more helpful tips to help you manage your WordPress website. And thanks for watching.